21st Precinct, Sergeant Waters. Yeah, that's right. Those are policemen working over there. What do you want to know for? Well, how does what they're doing concern you? Yeah. Yeah. Well, you just have to bear us up.
You are by transcription in the muster room at the 21st Precinct, the nerve center. A call is coming through. You will follow the action taken pursuant to that call from this minute until the final report is written in the 124 room at the 21st Precinct.
All right. Yeah, we'll be through there right away, as soon as possible. Yes, sir. You're welcome.
21st Precinct. It's just lines on a map of the city of New York. 173,000 people wedged into 9/10 of a square mile between Fifth Avenue and the East River. The security of their homes, their persons, and their property is the job of the men of the 21st Precinct.
The 21st. 160 patrolmen, 11 sergeants, and 4 lieutenants, of whom I'm the boss. My name is Keel, Thomas P. Keel. I'm captain in command of the 21st Precinct. I was doing night duty, 4 p.m. to 8 a.m. After I turned out the platoon at midnight, I went into my office to read and sign reports and communications that had piled up. Meanwhile, the men were taking over their posts, and one of them, Patrolman Daniel Mercado, walked over the prescribed route from the station house to Madison Avenue. After leaving Patrolman Edward Farrell on his assigned post, he began to try the doors to the shops along the avenue. As he was in the process of this operation, the car in which Sergeant William Waters was riding as recorder and Patrolman Joseph Ahern as operator pulled up to the curb.
Okay. Stay in the car while I talk to him.
Yes, sir.
Mercado.
Yes, Sergeant?
There's a street light out down the next block. Did you report it?
Farrell said it had been out for about 2 hours when I relieved him. He reported it.
Okay.
He said they're on the way to fix it.
All right. If it's still out at the end of the tour, I'll make another report of it.
Yes, sir. And I've been having trouble on this whole circuit up here the last couple of days.
What's that?
What's what?
I'm knocking.
I don't hear any knocking, Sarge.
Stop now. There it is.
It sounds like somebody hitting a window.
Where's it coming from?
Everything's closed in the block.
What about upstairs in one of the apartments?
Could be, Sarge.
Hold it.
I don't think it's from upstairs.
Ahern!
Sounds like it's from way down that way, Sergeant.
Yes, Sergeant.
Come here.
Yes, sir.
There it is, Sergeant.
Yeah, I think it's from way down that way, the next block.
Yes, Sergeant.
Hi, Merc. Joe.
Somebody's knocking on some glass, Ahern.
I don't hear.
Well, wait just a second. You will.
There it is.
Oh, yeah. From down the next block.
What do you think, Joe?
Got me. Could be coming from across the street.
Hold it. Ahern.
Yes, sir?
Now, we'll walk down. You bring the car.
Okay, sir.
Come on, Mercado.
There it is. Still sounds from down that way.
Come on. Keep your eyes on those apartment windows upstairs.
Yeah, okay.
I'll look in the stores.
Boy, it rings out like a bell.
Sure does. There's nothing to stop it at this time of night. Yeah?
Down here. The drugstore.
Okay.
Drugstore's closed.
Ahern, who is it?
Somebody inside.
What?
Somebody inside the drugstore, he said.
Somebody inside.
Burglars?
No, Sergeant. Not burglars. Woman's locked in there.
All right, lady, take it easy. Take it easy.
Can you get me out?
How did you get in? Lady, you'll have to come closer to the door and talk a little bit louder. I can't hear what you're saying.
I was in the telephone booth when the store closed.
In the telephone booth?
Yes, that's right.
Wouldn't you know it?
All right.
I was in the telephone booth and all of a sudden the lights went out. I didn't know what happened. I hung up and the place was closed. It was locked tight.
How long ago was this?
What?
How long ago was it?
I don't know. I hadn't any idea. About 10 or 15 minutes ago.
He usually closes between 12 and 12:30, Sergeant. He was closed when I came on post. I think he was.
What did he say?
He was talking to me.
Oh, I think I will catch somebody's attention. I've been just standing here knocking on the door with a half dollar.
All right, lady.
I would have called the police, but the guy... dime I used in the phone was the last dime or quarter or nickel I had. All I had was the half dollar.
Now, look. Don't get panicky. Just take it easy. We'll get you out.
I'm not panicky. I'm just trying to tell you what happened. I know I'll get out.
Good.
I was getting a little worried until somebody heard me, but I know I'll be all right now.
Yeah, you'll be fine. Now, what I want you to do is reach up on the inside of the door. See if you can find a latch to turn.
You mean a knob?
That's right. See if you can find a knob.
The only thing is this. And I tried that before.
That won't do it.
The key's the only thing that'll open that, Sergeant.
Listen, the store has a burglar alarm service. They always have a key at the office.
Well, that'd be a sign that says protected by Holmes or Burns Patrol or whoever it was.
Well, yes, sir, usually.
There's no back door, is there, Mikado?
No, sir. This is the only way in or out.
Let me put my light up on the transom there.
There's no transom, Joe.
You think there's anything you can do?
We'll get you out. Don't worry about it.
I'm not worried.
What building is this in, number 24?
Yes, Sergeant, 24.
All right, Ahern, walk around the corner of the building entrance. Find what apartment the superintendent lives in. See if he's got a key to this door.
Yes, sir.
All right, get going.
I'm on my way, Sergeant.
Mikado.
Yes, sir.
Go to the call box and ring in. Tell the lieutenant what we've got.
Yeah, okay, Sergeant.
He might want to check Holmes Detective anyway and Burns. What's the name of the druggist?
Erding. Paul Erding.
All right, go on.
Yeah, okay, Sergeant.
Oh. Yes, lady?
You're not going away and leave me?
No, we're not going anyplace.
Oh, that's good. I saw them leave.
I sent them to see if they could find somebody with a key.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome. Now, listen.
Yes?
Didn't the druggist know you were in the telephone booth?
No, I guess he didn't. It's in a funny place, way in the back, in an alcove almost.
Was he alone in the store?
I think so.
Didn't he see you come in?
What?
Didn't he see you when you came in the store?
Maybe he did, but I was in the booth so long, I guess he forgot.
What's your name?
Grace Nehart.
How do you spell that?
G-R-A-C-E.
The last name.
Oh, N-E-I-H-A-R-T.
Is that Miss or Mrs.?
Miss.
Where do you live?
Around the corner there at number 22.
Don't you have a phone in your apartment?
Oh, yes.
Why don't you use that instead of coming down here?
Well, the call I was making was of rather a personal nature. I didn't care to have my roommate overhear it.
Oh, I see.
What did you say?
I said I see. I understand.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
How long do you think I have to stay in here?
Until we can find someone with a key.
Do you know someone?
Well, it's in this apartment, Billy. The super might have a key.
You think so?
Maybe. And if the druggist subscribes to the burglar alarm service, they'll have a key for sure.
It doesn't look to me like he subscribed to it. It's such a small store. And besides, there's none of that silvery paint on the windows.
Well, there's all kinds of burglar alarms.
Oh. Supposing he doesn't subscribe.
Then we've got the owner's name and number and phone at the file on the station house. We'll get him down here to open up.
I don't think he's going to like that very much.
He should have looked around the store before he locked up.
What did you say?
He should have looked around the store better.
What's the tumult here? What's the tumult?
All right, keep moving.
Well, I'm sorry. Excuse me, officer. I didn't mean to usurp your prerogative.
You're not usurping anything, mister. You just better go on home and get in bed.
Well, what have we got? A damsel in distress? Oh, you!
Go on, go on. You better hit the ties.
Oh, we'll put her in there. Yoo-hoo!
Get moving.
Listen, I am not drunk. I'm only offering you my technical know-how for the damsel in distress. If you think I'm drunk again...
Yeah, I think so.
You were perfectly mistaken. All I had was one rock on the scotch with a whisk of penman wheel.
Now, look. Get going. Go on home.
All right. The word from the wise is sufficient. Yo! Good night. Good night. Good night, sweet damsel in distress.
Well, he was a big help.
I was worried. I thought you were going to arrest him.
Him? No, we've got bigger troubles.
I said he's got bigger troubles. You know, I'm beginning to get a little bit worried.
What?
I'm beginning to get a little bit worried, I said.
Are you in a hurry to get any place?
No.
Will anyone be concerned about you?
That's my roommate, but I don't care about her or whether she's concerned.
All right, then, relax. Enjoy the fuss that's being made over you.
I can't relax.
You'll relax before. We'll get you out, don't worry.
I know you'll get me out. I have no doubt about that. I'll try to be calm and collected, but I just feel that I'm going to lose control. I feel so ridiculous in here.
How do you think I feel out here?
What?
Nothing.
I bumped the desk off, Sergeant.
Yeah, what did he say?
Well, he rang over to home. This store isn't a subscriber. They got no key. Burns either.
I didn't think they would be.
How's she doing?
She's still in there.
Is there any news? Did you find the key?
No, not yet.
Sergeant, the lieutenant got the owner's name from the business house file. Like I told you, it's Erding. Paul Erding. He lives up in Washington Heights. The lieutenant said if the super didn't have a key to ring in again, and he'd get hold of Mr. Erding right away.
Okay. Yes?
What's going on? What are you plotting out there?
We're not plotting anything, lady. Except how to get you out.
Here's a hand, Sergeant. How'd you do, Joe?
I woke up the super, Sergeant.
Yeah?
He's got no key to any of these stores.
Uh-huh.
All he handles is the residential apartments in the building. These stores here are handled direct by the office.
Okay. Mikado, you better ring into the lieutenant again. Tell him we can't locate a key.
Yeah, okay. Right away, Sergeant.
Cooper said he'd come and see if he could give us a hand as soon as he gets dressed, but doesn't know what there is he can do.
There's no other way out of this door, is there?
No, sir, he says there isn't, just this door here.
Yes, lady?
Did you get a key?
No, not yet.
I thought that policeman went to wake up the super of the building.
He did. The super's got no key to any of the stores.
Well, what are we going to do? How am I going to get out?
We'll get you out.
You keep saying that, but you don't do anything.
Just don't worry.
I am worried. I'm getting worried to death.
We got the home telephone number of the druggist in the files at the station house. The other officer went to the call box. He's going to ask the lieutenant to phone the druggist to come down here.
Do you think he'll come?
He'll come, yeah.
He might not feel very good about it.
He might not feel very good about it, but he'll come.
Well, I hope so.
What's that super's name, Ahern?
Charlie.
You said he'd come out as soon as he got dressed?
Yeah, Sergeant. He doesn't know what he can do, though.
Yes, ma'am?
Where did this druggist live?
In Washington Heights.
How long did it take him to get here?
About a half hour. A little more, maybe.
My goodness.
What?
I said, my goodness.
Oh. You ring in, Mikado?
Yes, sir, I rang in. The desk officer called up the druggist's home.
Is he coming down to open up?
No, sir. His wife said he wasn't there.
Well, maybe he didn't have time to get home yet.
He's not coming home. He doesn't live there. His wife told the lieutenant they were separated about a month ago.
Yeah?
If all this concerns me, I wish you'd let me know what's going on.
Just a second, lady. Where does the wife say he's living now?
And she told the lieutenant she doesn't know.
Well, she knows how to get in touch with him when she has to, doesn't she?
Well, yes, sir, she knows that.
Well, where does she reach him?
Right here. Right here at the store.
I remained occupied with my paperwork, which consisted mainly of various reports concerning occurrences in the precinct, to be endorsed by me and forwarded through channels for about 25 minutes. Then I got up and walked out into the muster room, where I saw Lieutenant Matt King, commander of the 21st Detective Squad, come in the front door of the station house. Matt?
Hello, Captain.
I see you're coming in when you should be going out. Why don't you go home?
Well, I thought about it, Captain. I've got the line up in the morning. I just used one of the beds upstairs.
Mm-hmm. Well, how about a cup of coffee?
Yeah, sure.
Fred, is the coffee hot?
Yes, sir. There's some sugar in the drawer.
Okay. What's keeping you around here so late, Matt? Go ahead.
Well, Ludd and Scanlon got hold of a boy who said he knew where to find that Miyota kid.
Oh, yeah? Here.
Thanks. That's good, kid.
Yeah.
sugar?
Yeah, thanks.
Did you collar him?
Well, this boy said Neota was staying over in a flat on West 96th Street, but he heard he had a Luger over there besides the gun he used to shoot up the liquor store.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought we better be ready for anything over there. I took Danny Goldman in addition to Ludd and Scanlon, and we picked up another couple of men from the squad over there. We went up there to hit the flat.
Yeah?
Well, we hit the door, and there was only this babe inside. A girl, 18 or 19. She was scared half to death. I asked her whose flat it was. Said a friend of hers, a fellow named Kenny. Kenny Rumor, Numer, or something.
Mm-hmm.
I said, are you sure his name isn't Phil Neota? No, she said, his name is Kenny. Well, she was telling what she knew, all right. Yes, coffee sure hits the spot.
Yeah, it helps, I'll say that.
Anyway, she described this, Kenny. The way she talked, she was talking about the Neota kid. So we gave the place good going over, top to bottom. Wasn't anything there. She said he gave her the key and told her to meet him there. He'd be home like 10 o'clock. Well, we sat down to wait, Ludd and Scanlon and I. 10 o'clock, 10:30, 11 o'clock. Finally, at 11:45, there's a noise out in the hall. Key in the door. Door opened. We jumped.
But it's not the Neota boy.
I don't know. You have scared this Kenny out of his wits. Fairly close to the physical description of Neota, but that's about all. Good, hard-working fellow. Well, that's how I spent the evening.
Mm-hmm. Where are Ludd and Scanlon?
Oh, them? They went out to find the boy that gave them this hot information.
I don't blame them.
Excuse me, Captain.
Yes, Lieutenant.
Hi, Red.
What?
We got a woman locked in a drugstore on Post 14.
How did she get in there?
She was in the phone booth and the druggist closed up.
Mm-hmm.
Super, the building says she's got no key. She got out the druggist's phone number from the business file. His wife says she separated from him for about a month and she doesn't know where he's living.
Have they got a burglar alarm service?
I checked homes, Captain. Store isn't a subscriber.
Who's on the job over there?
Sergeant Waters, Captain, and Mercado and Ahern. Sergeant says the woman started off kind of cool and collected when they first got there. She's getting a little panicky now.
Are you making any further effort to locate the druggist?
Yes, sir. He's got a mother, lives in the Bronx. According to the wife, the mother's got no phone. She doesn't think he's living with the mother, but the mother might know where he is. I got the 50th Precinct and sent a man over there to talk to the mother.
Any friends of the man or employees of the store?
The wife says he's got a pharmacist working for him, a new one. She doesn't know his name. Came to work after they got separated. She used to help him out in the store herself.
She doesn't happen to have the key around the house, eh?
No, sir. Sergeant Waters wants to know what I thought about sending for the emergency squad to take the door off or cut the glass out or whatever they can do to get her out.
Well, you better hold up on that for a while, Wren.
Yes, sir.
I'll take a ride over there and see what it looks like. Have the car come around for me.
Okay. Right away, Captain.
You want to take a look, Matt?
No, Captain, no thanks. I spend too much of my time now seeing people who are locked up.
In a few minutes, Sector Car Number 3 came by the house for me and drove me over to the drugstore on Madison Avenue, where, by this time, a few people had gathered despite the lateness of the hour. As the car pulled to a stop behind the sergeant's car, I could see considerable activity in the doorway. All right. Wait here.
All right, folks. There's nothing to see. You might just as well move on. Captain?
Hello, Ahern. Where's Sergeant Waters?
In the doorway there, talking to her.
Okay.
Yes, sir. All right, let's just keep moving, huh?
Sergeant?
Oh, hello, Captain.
How are you doing?
Well, she's still in there.
Mm-hmm.
Miss Mehart?
Yes?
I sent one of the officers with the super of the building. They went to call somebody from the real estate company. We'll see if they've got a key.
It's getting to be an awfully long time.
We'll know something in a few minutes.
You've been saying that. You've been saying we'll know something in a few minutes. An awful long time has gone by.
We're doing everything we can.
I don't know about that. I don't know if you are. I'm still locked in here.
I'm Captain Keogh. We'll get you out. We'll get you out very soon.
What?
You got to talk closer to the door, Captain. I said we'll get you out very soon.
I hope so. I only hope so.
She's in there too much longer, Captain. She's going to go to pieces.
Well, I don't know whether I'd blame her.
No, sir, neither would I. I was thinking about getting the emergency truck over here and taking that door off or the glass out or something.
Well, I don't think they could take the door off. They're butted hinges.
If you jimmy it open.
No, that'd cause a lot of damage. The best thing might be to cut the glass down.
Yes, sir.
McCarter went with the super?
Yes, sir.
Who are they calling?
Well, some executive from the real estate company that manages this building.
Mm-hmm.
The super says he might know where there's a key to the store. If he doesn't, he might know who to call. Mm-hmm. There she goes again.
Officer?
Yes?
Any news?
They haven't come back yet.
Oh. I'm getting very thirsty.
Thirsty?
Yes. Very thirsty.
Why don't you go behind the soda fountain and get a glass of water?
You think it would be all right?
It'll be all right, sure.
If you say so.
Yes, go ahead.
All right, I will.
Well, that'll keep her busy for a minute anyway.
Yeah.
Hearn.
Captain.
Call me, Sergeant.
The captain did.
Oh, yes.
Take a walk down to the call box. Ring into Lieutenant Gorman and see if he's had any luck in locating the druggist.
Yes, sir.
And tell him I'll be here until we get her out.
Okay, Captain, I'll tell him.
Let me know what he says.
Yes, sir.
The 50th was going to send a man around to his mother's place.
Yeah, I know.
All right, Miss Neihardt. We're right here.
I got my drink of water.
Well, that's good.
And I found this chair, too. There's no sense standing here when I can be sitting.
Yeah, you'll be a lot more comfortable.
It's not how comfortable I am that makes a difference. But I'm getting very nervous.
What?
I'm getting very nervous. I want to get out of here.
All right, we'll get you out.
I want to get out now. Right now. There's no reason why I can't get out right now.
Like I told you, lady, if we can't find somebody with a key, we'll get the emergency squad over here to take off the door.
I'd sure like to know when.
Very soon.
You've been saying that.
Just relax and you'll be all right.
Yes, Mikado.
Captain, this is Charlie, the super at number 28.
I'm glad to know you, Captain.
Hello.
Some deal we got here.
Yes. Do you have any luck?
No luck at all. I went inside. I called up my boss, which is Mr. Doyle.
Did he have a key?
Well, Mr. Doyle's got charge of apartment rentals only, so he told me to call up Mr. Matthews, which is in charge of business rentals. I said, look, Mr. Doyle, Mr. Matthews don't know me from a hole in the ground, so Mr. Doyle called up Mr. Matthews, and Mr. Doyle called me back.
Well, did Mr. Matthews have the key?
I know, sir. They said they've got no keys to any of these stores.
Well, at least that's what Mr. Doyle told me, Mr. Matthews told me.
I talked to Mr. Doyle, Captain. He said that Mr. Matthews assured him there was no master key to these stores in their office. The only one who had the key is the tenant.
I rang into the house, Captain.
Yes, I heard. Lieutenant Gorman says the 50th got back to him. They sent a man by the house of the man's mother. Mm-hmm. She doesn't know where he's living. She hasn't heard from him in over a month.
Captain.
Okay.
Now, look, Miss Neihardt, put the chair down. Put it down.
No. Here.
We've got the emergency squad on the way, Miss Neihardt.
You'll be saying that.
Now put that chair down.
What's up, Sergeant?
You better get back, McCarter.
Oh, lady. Take
the rest of them back.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Now, take it easy.
Miss Neihardt.
Get out of the way.
I think he means it, Captain.
Get back.
Put that chair down. We'll get you out.
Get back.
Come on, Captain.
Miss Neihardt.
Captain, come on.
You all right, sir?
Yeah, I'm all right.
Sorry I pushed you, Captain. But I saw that chair coming down.
Oh, don't worry about it. Thanks.
Yes, sir.
Well, I did it.
Yeah, you did it.
I had to. Please help me.
Now, don't step through there yet. There's a lot of jagged glass hanging there. Mikado.
Yes, Captain, right here.
Take a nightstick and clean that glass off around there.
Yes.
Stand a few feet back in there, Miss Neihardt.
I want to come out.
You'll be able to step out in a minute.
All right. If it's only going to be a minute.
Excuse me, son.
Go ahead, McCarter. It's all yours.
Yes, sir.
Okay, McCarter. That's good. Well, Captain, I guess she solved the problem for us.
Yeah. From now on, I don't think she'll mind if her roommate overhears her phone conversation.
My first precinct, Sergeant Waters. Well, who are you, the watchman? Well, what'd they break into? Did you see the thieves? Yeah. Yeah. Well, what's missing? Oh? Yeah. Yeah. Well, what was all that doing in a tool shed? Yeah. Well, was it locked? Yeah. The lock was jimmied off, huh? All right. I'll send the officers right over there. Yeah. Wait right at the gate.
And so it goes. Around the clock. Through the week. Every day. Every year. The police precinct in the city of New York is a flesh and blood merry-go-round. Anyone can catch the brass ring. Or the brass ring can catch anyone.
21st Precinct, transcribed. A factual account of the way police work in the world's greatest city is presented with the official cooperation of the Patrolmen's Benevolent Association, an organization of more than 20,000 members of the Police Department, City of New York. Les Gaiman in the role of Captain Keogh, Ken Lynch as Lieutenant King, Harold Stone as Sergeant Waters. Featured in tonight's cast were John Sylvester, Bill Quinn, Abby Lewis, Santos Ortega, and Lawson Zerbe. 21st Precinct is written, produced, and directed by Stanley Nitz. Art Hannah speaking.